Oh, hey there. Someone's glowing.
The bad gal's expanding her beauty empire and blessing our faces. Stay tuned for our honest review of Rihanna's Fenty Skin. Welcome to Style Trial. It's been a while, but we are back and coming at you from the comfort of our own homes. When it comes to beauty and skincare, we are fully invested, especially when it means we may have the chance to get a glow like Rihanna's. So in honor of her Fenty Skin line, which launched just last week, I invited my coworker and fellow beauty buff Kayla to give the products a whirl.
Rihanna's much anticipated skincare line, it's clean, it's vegan, it's friendly on the earth, and it's gender neutral.
Checks all the boxes. So over the past week, both Kayla and I have tried all three of the Fenty Skin starters. That begins with the Total Cleanser, which is a combination face wash and makeup remover, Fat Water, amazing name, which is a toner slash serum, and Hydravisor, which is a moisturizer with added SPF 30. Okay, so let's start with Total Cleanser. Now, I don't know about you, Kayla, my first reaction when I opened the little twist top, which is super convenient and cute, is fragrance.
Smells really nice.
This has one, it's noticeable. It sort of smells like floral and fruity, if that makes sense. I think that might come from the Barbados cherry that's in all of these products. Very Rihanna to use Barbados cherry. Were you bothered by it at all?
I wasn't bothered by the cleanser so much. I think my only concern with the cleanser is that it does have a nice lather to it, but I was kind of concerned if the lather was too much. Could this dry my skin out?
My skincare routine can best be described as I use whatever my dermatologist tells me to. I have super dry, sensitive skin, acne prone. I've dealt with acne for decades, literal decades. Oddly, the fragrance, while noticeable, didn't seem to irritate my skin, which I was really happy to see. I also love, like you were mentioning that sudsy, foamy cleansers often are very stripping, and they can leave your skin feeling really tight and dry.
You know, Alana, even if the cleanser was a little drying, it was balanced out by the Fat Water toner slash serum that kind of gave my skin a nice, supple, and soft feel.
I feel like of all the reviews I've read online and all the hype I've read about Fenty Skin, this was the product that most people were really excited to try. Probably partly because of the name, but also like, look at that consistency. It's like ooey gooey.
I loved using it, and I've switched toners in the past because of the, you know, alcohol in it and, you know, trying different things. So having a toner that works for me is key, and I do like this one.
So I do want to note that I've been using this product for the past 3 or 4 days. It makes my skin feel very clean, and I do kind of see the glow already.
I'd be curious to see if I see a noticeable improvement long-term with this. They're very gentle, which is great in one regard, but like, are they too gentle?
One of the benefits of this toner and serum is that you don't need a cotton ball. You twist the top open, you pour a little bit on your hand, and then you just dab it in your face.
Okay, so lastly, we have Hydravisor, and this for me was probably the product I was most excited about going into this trial. It's a combination moisturizer and SPF. It's got SPF 30. Always thinking about the planet, she made it refillable. So the first time you order this, it comes with both components, but after that you can just order the refill, which just twists nicely into the bottle and then you pump it out. But my biggest concern going into this, or rather the thing I was most excited to see, was how this would mix with my makeup. Because Rihanna said, you know, she designed it to be super seamless under your face with makeup, no matter how much you wear or what you wear.
I'm impressed. The concealer and the Hydravisor mixed really beautifully, went on smoothly, didn't feel too heavy. You know, seems truly makeup friendly as it claims to be.
I had mixed reviews about this because on one end, I noticed that you can't use too much because even though it says that it's not greasy, the more that you use, being that it's a moisturizer and an SPF, it can greasy if you use too much.
I do like it. It does feel fragrant. I think my only issue with it is that what if you just don't want a fragrance and you just want to feel clean and you just want a soft scent.
Kayla, did you go outside with this on at all?
I did. I went grocery shopping and I wore it underneath the face mask.
There's not a lot of perspiration. It seems to like be like seemingly dry. So again, like I don't, but I also wouldn't put a lot of moisturizer / sunscreen under it. So I like it so far.
Okay, so let's talk about the price point of these products for a second. The Total Cleanser comes in at $25. The Fat Water is $28. And the Hydrovisor, which is sold both in its entirety and with just the refill, costs $35 for the whole thing, $30 for the refill. How do we feel about the value of these products?
So compared to the typical brands that I've used, I've noticed that I'm getting a lot of bang for my buck in these sizes, especially with the, you know, the serum and toner is 5 fluid ounces.
I think the price point's really reasonable, but it remains to be seen how effective this is from a treatment perspective long-term. I kind of get the sense that when Rihanna created Fenty Skin, she wasn't setting out to make a treatment line. She's, you know, trying to make something fun, easy to use that her fans would like. And these are very fun to use. I have to hand it to her. But the question remains, amidst all the hype, do these products work, 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 work?
I don't know, Alana, but I'm shining bright like a diamond.
You are.